What's up, West Coast Swing fans? In this video, we're gonna cover
seven whips.
Seven whips you need to know for West Coast Swing. These are gonna be from beginner to super cool, seven fun whips for West Coast Swing. Let's break them down real quick, give you a quick demo, and then we'll teach you how to do each one. All right, gang, whip number one, we're gonna teach you how to do a basic whip. That's the basic whip. That one's kind of boring, but if we use basic whip footwork, we can do whip number two, the hustle whip. Then if I have two hands, I can do what's called a basket whip. That's whip number three. Then we're gonna have to, we don't actually have to change hands. We have a reverse whip, which is number four. Boom. Number five is going to be a version of a reverse whip. I will need a cross hand hold for this. We call this the decapitative whip. This is one of my favorite patterns. A decapitative whip, because if we don't do it properly, we'll decapitate our partner. Then we're gonna do a behind the back whip, so I can look at the camera while I'm talking to you. And then we're gonna use a non-traditional man's or leader's right to follower's left to do a pull-through whip that looks super cool. So let's go through these one by one. Whip number one, and we'll put a stamp signature below this. So if you wanna jump to one of the other whips, we'll give you a link right below this that you can click and link to the specific one you wanna learn. But let's get started with the basic whip. Basic whip footwork for the leaders. We have one, we get out of the slot for two. That's the key. Three and four, I go across the slot. Small step for five, back in the slot for six, anchor seven and eight. So the keys for the leaders are going to be to not progress this way on the whip, but to come back and either cross or even back and together is what I teach beginners. Then on count four, three and four, I need to make sure I'm across the slot. I'm not in my follower's way. Out for five, back in for six, anchor seven and eight. Followers footwork real quick with a couple of keys.
All right, so followers, we're gonna go forward, turn, back together, forward, turn, step back, triple step. So if we do that again, we have one, turning, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. The important part about this, one, two, three, and making sure that your heels are down and you're connected away before you go to count four.
So if we look at that this way, you can see it real cool. In a basic whip, one of the ways that I think about this is we have a stretched connection on this side, right? Anytime we do a sugar push, we have a stretched connection away. There's a stretched connection on the other side of the whip. This is gonna apply for all the whips we do, and I wanna show it to you real soon. One, two, three, and. So on three and, I should be on my right foot. I'm out of the slot, Megan's on her left foot, and she's connected away. If we can achieve that, then any movement across the slot is going to cause Megan to move, right? So keys for your basic whip. Number one, the leader does not cut the follower off. That's for the leaders. For the followers, small steps on one, two. So you're turning around pretty much in front of the leaders so that you can feed back for three and. See how comfy that is for me? For both of us, really. I step across for four, five, six, seven, and eight. So there are your keys to a basic whip. Now, if we take the same concept and the same footwork and we change the handhold and the spacing a little bit, we're gonna have a hustle whip. So whip number two, our West Coast Swing whip number two, we can use this, let's start with two hands. A hustle whip looks like this. A one, two, three, and four, a five, six, seven, and eight. So the footwork is strikingly similar to the basic whip footwork. The only thing I need to do is I need to cultivate the ability to maintain connection when I get close and further away. And I can even maintain connection moving this way. So as a drill, I wanna be able to maintain connection. We're using our elbows, drawing back, keeping connection in both hands as our arms widen. The old school teachers used to say reading the paper. If you're young, you probably don't have a newspaper. I did not have a paper route, just to tell you. And then the other one is I wanna cultivate the ability to not let this go slack, but to have there be a little bit of ability here. So that way when I lead my hustle whip, I still have to lead one, two to get Megan to step back, right? So I have to lead using my left hand a little bit of a pull forward, right? Just like I would in a basic whip, a little bit of a pull forward to turn her around. Same thing happens with the hustle whip. One, two. Now what do you think about there, Miss Megan? What are you following? How do you feel this?
I am staying connected and actually mainly connected away, but it's like out to the side. So you wanna flare your elbows. That way I feel every direction that the leader's leading me in.
There you go. So we have one, two. So I'm combining two things, leaders. Number one, the ability to separate my arms a little bit. Number two, the ability to maintain connection when I widen my arms. So we have one, two. Now, I'm going to allow Megan. She's going back for three and. So that's the stretch at the other side of the whip that we talked about in the beginner video. Now, I feed her forward on count four, right? I use that hand forward for four. Then I'm going to feed her back for five. Again, widening my hands. I'm sorry, that's six. Count six. Six, seven, and eight. There you go. Jeepers creepers. I freaked out at myself. So again, I lead forward for one, back for two. I allow her to go back for three, and we're stretched away, right? Now I put her on count four. I reverse for five, six, seven, and eight. So that, and you can do this from two hands, or you can pick up the second hand as you go, and then you have a hustle whip. Since we have two hands, whip number three for West Coast Swing is our basket whip. So the basket whip, basic whip footwork for the leader. The followers are gonna go down the slot and then come back.
We have a whole lot of work to do.
To return. So just recover that footwork. Leaders, basic footwork, right out of beginner class, everything remains the same, right? Followers, a little bit different.
Followers, you're gonna feel like you're not doing a whole lot because you're not. You're walking forward, you're walking back. So we have one, two together for three and four. We're only going back as far as we feel the connection go. Then five, six, seven, and eight. So one more time. Forward, forward. Together, together, back, back, back. Triple step.
And like we talked about in the basic whip video, there is a stretch on this side of a basic whip. There's also a stretch on this side of a basic whip. And that's gonna be maintained through all of these whips that we do. So even though we're doing the basket whip, right, we're anchored and stretched away here, right? Arm-wise, this is gonna come up and over, right? We're using our little baby steps as we go back away. So you can just use baby steps to understand the hand. The elbow stays out to create a space for Megan to go in, right? And what I'm trying to do is let her get to the end of that little mini stretch position. It's not gonna feel very stretched because only my arms are available to stretch, but that's the path that Megan's taking the reverse whip. If we add footwork to it, I like to do this from a two-hand hold. It's possible to do it this way and pick this hand up as we go, but it decreases the likelihood that someone's gonna follow it unless they're pretty advanced. So I start with two hands. Oh, one, two, three, and four, a five, six, seven, and eight. Any tips connection-wise, arm-wise for the followers?
Yes, followers, you really wanna pay attention to staying connected to the other side. One, two, three, and. So I am making sure that I stay connected here and I only move back when I feel the leader move me. And it's not going to be a very big step because all they're doing is coming across the slot. That movement's only gonna be very small.
The analogy that I use is the skaters or skateboarders and the half pipe. So when they jump off here and they come up, there's a delay before they come back down. We all know the direction's changing, right? They've gone down, there's a lot of momentum, they decelerate and accelerate. So there's a stretch at that side. So in all of our whips, even though the basket whip has only a mini stretch, there's a deceleration as that goes back. So that is whip number three, that's your basket whip. Whip number four is your reverse whip. So in the reverse whip, the follower's direction is different in the beginning of the whip, meaning she doesn't turn towards me, she turns away. So basic whip, she turns towards me, right? So that means a reverse whip, she's gonna turn away from me. And the reverse whip is cool, there's lots of different options. Good news, leaders, footwork is basic whip footwork. So again, I'll reiterate some of the keys to this for the leaders. Don't cut the followers off on count two. So on one, two, I can cut my foot across. I can come together depending upon the spacing. But what I really want to not do is step down line because it's going to cut off the amount of space that the follower has. That's key number one. Key number two is three and I'm across the slot on four. Right? Always, always, always. I don't want to be in the way. Across the slot on four. I'm out of the way for five, back in for six, seven, and eight. Followers, pay attention because your footwork is trickier.
I'm going to do it from this side. So followers, we are going to be turning over our left shoulder, but first we have two walks. So you're going to go forward, forward. Now we're going to turn to our left. Turn, step together, forward. From here, you're doing the exact same thing as your whip. You're going to turn, step back, triple simple step. So again, we have 1, 2, turning, 3 and 4, turn, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
So let's talk two things. Number one, we'll talk the lead. I'll actually lead the, I'll leave you on that side so the followers can follow the same way. Let's talk a little bit about the lead and follow, and then let's talk about the stretch that we talk about that should exist in all of our whips. So first things first, lead-wise, I need to lead Megan prepped forward on her left foot. So I feel like I need a walk forward and a prep. So I'm shifting this arm out, not a lot, but enough to get her to respond. The better our connection is, the smaller that will show. So as new dancers, it looks like sort of a big deal, right? But as really good dancers, it's very subtle, the movement, right? So that's 1, 2, 1, 2. So what I've done is set her up to be able to be prepped to rotate the other way. This hand goes up and over as I pick up her back for 3 and. So this is the same stretch position that we'll get to in all of our whips on 3 and. We go across for 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So one of the ways to practice that, we always use baby steps. So baby steps, don't even worry about where we're going. Just take this hand up and over, rotate her to get to this position, come back across so you get an understanding. I actually like this. This is pretty fun, right? So I understand the hand path of the whip, right? So that will give you the structure. Then we have to put the footwork underneath it. Footwork for all these patterns is, I think, most important for the followers. Because if you notice, leaders are working off the same footwork. Followers are going to have slight different variations. So we'll look at it from this side and the other side. We have 1, we lead 2, we go over for 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If we do it from the other side, the reverse side of the reverse whip, does that mean it's just a basic whip? Probably not. So a 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now we talked about there being a stretch at the end of all of our whips, right? Let's go back to the basic whip. There is a stretch 3 and on that side. And we come back across, and obviously we have the stretch on the anchor, right? Same thing's gonna happen on the reverse whip, so we have to keep the beginning part of it tight. 3 and, right? So Megan has enough room to stretch back. That's the and. Now we come across 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Can you give a couple tips for the followers for that, to make sure that that's tight and connected?
Yeah, so followers, when we have 1, 2, my first turning step, I'm not going very long. I'm gonna stay kind of within the rotation that I'm in. Then on this next step, I can kind of fill out the connection if I need to.
That's count and. And as my good friend, Jason Miklick, shout out to Jason and Sophie up the road from us here, he calls this the circle of trust, right? So this is all happening in the circle of trust. Look how beautiful that is. My lead is so amazing. Or Megan did a great job as the follower because I'm off to the races with my reverse whip. So number 5, whip number 5 for West Coast Swing is our decapitative whip. It is a version of a reverse whip, so the footwork is going to remain pretty much the same. The only difference is we're going to do it from a right to right handhold, and it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now there's a couple variations we can use for that, but one more time. This is one of my most fun patterns. 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So basics of the reverse whip are there. So if you struggle with a reverse whip, go back and watch the move right before this where we cover the details of the reverse whip. The subtleties of the decapitative whip for West Coast Swing, right to right hand hold or handshake hold, put her there, pal. What's up? Lead is the same as a reverse whip where I have to lead Megan towards me for count 2. Now I'm gonna pick up her elbow for 3 and. I'm gonna place this over my head as I step across for 4, and we continue 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now, let's talk baby steps. So baby steps, no footwork, we just baby step our way through. This hand cuts through. I have to start to look for her elbow. So I'll start maybe on the shoulder, and I'll fish down to the elbow till I get to this position, right? Let's try that on this side maybe, right? Baby steps, baby steps, baby steps, over. I start to fish out the elbow, and I'm gonna get to a little bit of an angle with my body, and then I'm gonna lead her back down the slot. Bingo.
I think we're gonna create our own new dancing, shuffle swing.
The shuffle swing. So we try it from this side, baby steps, so you can kind of understand the angles of the hands, right? There's my 1, 2. We come over for 3 and, right? And to reach across, I have to kind of be able to create this angle, right? Then I'm gonna back myself out. And what I like to do is feed this hand down. I stay in contact with her, not pushing, but just stay in contact, right? That lets her know where the turn's going. It also lets her know where my hand is so she's not left out in no man's land. Cool? Now to speed, two beats at a time. One, two, we're still connected. Three and, right? So I can't quite reach through, no big deal. On count four, I can reach through. Notice my feet are across the slot, but I have to feed my left shoulder forward. Now, at this point, if you're super tall as a leader, you might not be able to get this over your head. Pop it on your shoulder, right? Now from here, either way, I slowly half turn back for five, half turn for six, anchor seven and eight. It's not a fast turn. Leaders don't push that hand. Turn. So let me do it one more time and I'll have Megan narrate the followers. A one, two, three, and four. A five, six, seven, and eight. So thoughts for the followers regarding that turn?
Followers, I'm gonna actually do the footwork for this separately. So we have one, two, three, and four. We're used to going backward on turning for five. Now we're just gonna turn for six, seven, and eight. Like he said, it's a very slow turn. We're not really spinning our way through it. So just make sure that you go nice and slow. One, two, three, and four. Slow, slow, and triple.
Beautiful, step. Let's try from the other side. And that's probably the biggest common problem because when we do the variations to this, and I'll give you a variation to this and I'll link it up, it's pretty fun. The fact that the follower will spin too fast will ruin the variation and actually open us to risk of injury. One, two, three, and four, a five, six, seven, and eight. And just to get you excited about what's possible, we do this with a leader's peel out. A one, two, three, and four, a five, six, seven, and eight. If you're interested in that video, we will link that up. But again, the key to that is the fact that Megan doesn't spin too fast. One, two, three, and four. If she goes slow for count five, then no one gets whacked. Six, seven, and eight. Watch what happens if she goes fast. Don't go too fast. One, two, three, and four. A five. If she starts going too soon, right, she's gonna end up eating this and it's gonna be a different move.
And then you can duck.
So that is pattern number five, West Coast Swing Whip number five. That's the decapitative whip. Number six is the behind the back whip. This is again a unique one. Unique one. Again, footwork for this one is actually different for the leaders. For the followers, it's not. So I'm gonna come out of the slot to the other side and I'll lead this with a single outside turn. There's options that don't have the turn. None of the followers like them, so we don't dance them too often. So basic whip for one, two, three, and four. Outside turn, anchor step. Let's talk leaders footwork. So leaders, this is an odd one. The rules of the whip are still the same. On one, two, I'm on this side of the slot to leave the slot for Megan. However, where I'm facing completely changes because it's a behind the back whip, it's happening behind me. So one, two, I'll take this foot out of the slot this way, right? The same rules of the whip for me being across the slot on four still apply. Three and four. So now I'm across the slot. Five, six, seven, and eight are all relatively the same. So if I do it again, one, two, I stay on this side for three and I have to work to get back across for count four. Now I can lead the turn five, six, seven, and eight. So five, six, seven, eight, all basic footwork. That is your footwork. Practice that a couple times. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. Followers forward real quick, basic stuff.
Followers, you have a whip with an outside turn. So you have one, two, three, and four, just like the last whip we did, nice and slow for five, six, seven, and eight. So if we did that one more time, one, two, three, and four, turn five, six, seven, and eight.
Cool, so lead-wise, let's practice this baby steps. So the first move is I have to change hands over the top. That's gonna happen on one, two, right? Then I'm gonna feed this hand behind me for three and four, and I'm gonna change to my left hand where I go up and over for five, six, seven, and eight. So if you're a hot shot, you got it now, but let's do baby steps. So baby steps, right? I'm leading Megan across behind me, changing my hand, right? I'm feeding it back, right? So that I can change to this hand, and we go up and over. Let's try that from the other side, maybe get a different view. Baby steps again. This is the first trick, leading the whip and changing to that, right? So baby steps, baby steps, baby steps, I change. I'm already connected there. If I'm good, I can feed this back and then forward, right? To change to my left hand. So I've got connection here, I'm gonna change to my left hand. Now we're staying in contact with that arm for this to go up and over for the turn, right? That is, even JT behind the camera is laughing. That is our behind the back whip. So, 2-beat increments, let's talk about the lead. I still have to lead 1-2 of a regular whip. That is the first priority as a leader. 1-2, once I accomplish the lead, I change to my right hand, right? Then I feed her back for 3 and I have to work to step across the slot for 4. As I do that for count 4, I start to connect to my left hand. Now, Megan has a half turn, and an anchor step. Let's do that one more time this way. Oh, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Turn 5, turn 6, 7, and 8. Let's reverse sides and I'll have Megan narrate that turn because
you have to stay connected. So we have a 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the leader is bringing their arm back to my other arm. Make sure though, before then, that you're staying connected to this hand behind his back. Now, he's going to be bringing his arm back to mine. They're going to, as we start to turn, probably slide a little bit, but you want to make sure that you're maintaining some connection toward this arm, that you can tell where they are taking you.
So we do it again. You're on, Megan.
1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So no matter how fast or slow, I'm being led by the pressure of this arm leading me around this circle. He could choose, not for this move, but he could choose to go faster or slower. It doesn't matter. I'm still connected and I can feel the speed based on that.
So if the followers stay connected and I lead slowly, then I should have whip number 6, the behind the back whip piece of cake. And of course, there's lots of different options I can use for this. You know, I can create pop-outs off this, lots of different things. If you want more cool options for what to do with the behind-the-back whip, we're gonna link up our pattern tree chart. You can get it in the description below. It lives over on our website. And what the pattern tree chart is it links the push, the pass, the whip to all of the variations. So if we're talking, this would be a whip, right? Then it would be a behind-the-back whip, and then you would get all the options of a behind-the-back whip. So you can click through the document to see all the patterns, and it's linked to all the patterns on our website. Super cool. It's free. Download it free. You can get up in the corner. So that is the behind-the-back whip with options for you. Whip number 7 for West Coast Swing is our pull-through whip. It's our final one. We'll do it from this side. It's actually going to go from a pretty non-traditional leader's right to follower's left, and it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, and 4 of 5, 6, 7, and 8. We'll look at that from the other side. This one's pretty fun, pretty modern. 1, 2, 3, and 4 of 5, 6, 7, and 8. So it too is based off of a reverse whip footwork for the followers. That is pattern number 4 in this video. If you want to cover the reverse whip, we'll link that below. Let's talk baby steps for the arms, right? So this is gonna come up and over Megan, right? I'm gonna work myself across the slot, and then for lack of better terminology, I'm gonna fling her behind my back to create the turn. Let's try that again. So we get to this handhold. We have a whole video on how to get to that handhold, but let's assume we're there. This is gonna go up and over in the reverse whip. I'm cutting across the slot. I have to make sure to prep her there, so there's a little bit of a prep there so I can send her for the turn, right? Now, let's do that from this side. 2-beat increments. 1-2, I'm still setting up the reverse whip. 1-2, so I'm setting Megan up prepped. We still have connection in this hand. I'm out of the slot. On 3 and 4, the basics of the whip still apply. I go up and over for 3 and, right? And we're connected on the and. As I step across on 4, I have not led. Notice Megan still has that prep position because I haven't pulled it out of her. We're still connected. Now, all I have to do is a little bit of a fling through this hand, and she'll start rotating 5, 6, 7, and 8. So footwork leaders, we go 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? I might move this right foot as long as it's on this side of the slot. It doesn't necessarily matter where I put it, as long as I can lead that five. I might be able to start to sneak in, back in for six, seven, and eight. So followers footwork.
Followers, you're doing your reverse whip with an outside turn. We did cover this for the decapitative whip, but you're going one, two, three, and four. Nice slow turn for five, six, seven, and eight.
Bingo. So two beat increments. We have one, two, we're connected. Three, and we're still connected at the other side. There's stretch there. We'll talk about that in a second. Four, right? We maintain that prep. That way, with a little bit of oomph, five, six, seven, and eight. So this is, we put this last because it's the most advanced of these, I think, in terms of the skill set needed to lead and follow it. But it's all the same basic stuff. In the basic video, we talked about there being two stretch points of a whip. Number one, we know the anchor step or stretch. The one that we all miss is the stretch point right here, three and. So on count three and, it's the end of the line on that side, right? And then it comes back across. The analogy I use is the half pipe, right? The skaters, skateboarders, they jump in, right? And they accelerate through the middle. They go up to the top and they decelerate before they come back down. Now we know it's coming back down, but there's a deceleration and an acceleration. So in our whips, there's an acceleration through the middle and a deceleration, and then an acceleration through the middle and a deceleration the other side. The same thing has to apply even though it's a behind or it's a pull through whip. One, two, three, and see the stretch? We still have stretch. You can feel it in our bodies. We're pretty good at this. Four, five, six, seven, and eight. Ooh, don't look at my footwork there. That was a bad one. One of my teachers said, Brian, when you're teaching, if you don't do the footwork correct, don't do it at all, just talk. That time, I talked and did the wrong footwork. So one, two, three, and we're stretched there, right? I use that stretch to make sure she's prepped because she needs to spin for count five, six, seven, and eight. So there is your behind the back whip. So to recap, we had a basic whip. Then we did a hustle whip, basic whip with two hands, right? If we kept two hands, we'd be able to do our reverse whip.
Or a basket whip.
Or a basket whip, basket whip, basket whip. Then we would do a reverse whip, which if we changed hands on the end of it, we could then do our decapitative whip. Then we're gonna do our behind the back whip. And then we'd need something like a good old fashioned sugar push to change our hands to do the pull through whip. So go ahead and practice those in sequence. They should work one through seven. Make sure you download our pattern tree chart. That's gonna be up in the corner here. That will teach you how to take all of our basic patterns, including these whips. You'll literally be able to go to that pattern tree chart, go whip. It will give you all the different whip options. You'll say behind the back whip, click, and it will give you all the options for the behind the back whip. So if you fall in love with one of these whips, you can go ahead and find all of the possible variations. And that will be linked up here. So head on over to the site, grab that, and we will see you again on a dance floor real soon.